dealt with probably the toughest problem that we could identify, which was trying to skill school dropouts. Now, I'll leave you with this thought that 80% plus youth in the country drop out of school. So 80% of youth in the country do not pass school, and that is immediately a handicap. Handicap is that most industry requires that a candidate or a student should be at least SSC pass. If he's not SSC pass, then he's not even allowed to apply. As a result, we also found that there weren't too many people doing anything about this at all. It was like a blind spot. 80% plus youth not passing school, dropping out. And how many people doing anything about it when we started in 98? Hardly anyone doing anything for dropouts. The National Skills Development Corporation has come up in the last 5 years. But before that, there was no one doing anything. It was a blind spot. So we decided to make that our mission. And I'm happy to say that over a period of time, the last 12 years, we've come a long way with one center in 98. We now have a presence in 8 states. We do 50,000 students a year. That would, as Mr. Chinoy said, probably make us the largest NGO in the skills development space. And we are able to place almost 60% of the youth that we skill. Now, this is with a handicap. A number of these people come from very poor areas and therefore at times not inclined to take up a job even after they've been trained. There are all kinds of issues, psychological, various other logistics, various other issues, which in fact we employ several trained counselors to counsel students so that they'll be able to come into the economic mainstream. Now, we conduct our project through 5 formats. The first format is, of course, we have our own centers, which currently number about 70. The second format is we handhold several other NGOs in different states to adopt our Yuva Parivartan model. If they want to enter the space, livelihood space or the skilling space, then they wouldn't know how to do it. So we have a partnership program where we actually teach the NGOs how to conduct vocational training, including fundraising, etc. The third format we have is camps. We found that people, students from or dropouts from rural areas or semi-urban areas could not attend our centers, which were largely urban or semi-urban. So we send teams into small towns and they conduct 10 to 15 day camps, teaching them one skill to be able to get gainful employment or self-employment in that place. For example, an electrician. We would teach him the bare essentials so he can do the wiring and various other related activities as well as connect up a motor or whatever it is in the rural areas. The fourth format we have is training for corporates and for government, in the sense there are several schemes started by various ministries of the government, as well as several corporates, including a number of Tata companies we work with, who want specific skills training done to specific target audiences. We undertake those in a fairly large measure. And the fifth is a pilot which we are doing. It's called the Integrated Rural Development Program, which comprises primarily of improved agricultural incomes, livestock, water resource, and SHGs. So that is in a pilot stage. So these are the 5 formats we work with. And since we are fairly professional, we employ people from IIMs and IITs and various other places who surprisingly come for half the salaries or one-third the salaries they would normally get in the corporate world. So we are fairly professional, and we are able to, therefore, we are kind of adopt all the corporate practices, and generally we find that our partners, corporate partners and others, stay with us for a very, very long period of time. We work in 5 areas. One is electrical and air conditioning, automotive, retailing, healthcare, and one more, garments. In these five areas, we are able to train. We have specific courses which are meant for school dropouts. Now, school dropouts, by the, you know, don't have too much of an attention span. So all our courses, and plus they don't want to stay too long because they also perhaps have to do occasional odd jobs and earn an income. So as a result, all our courses are designed for 2 hours a day, 5 days a week, and generally 3 to 4 months. So we do about 180 hours of training. And we found that it's enough because if our industry is employing our students, then it means that that is enough training. Because you'll find even if they are from ITIs, industrial training institutes, of which there is very little capacity, as was pointed out, we find that we are able to compete with the students who've passed out from ITIs. Because after all, a large part is learning on the job, is apprenticeship. If the, and I find, or we've found over a period of time, that their dropouts, not because they're less intelligent, it's just that there are various sets of factors which have contributed to this, intelligence not being one of them. As a result, they pick up fairly easily and have done very well over the last 12 years that we've been in this business. I'm happy to say that we've also tied up with an NGO in Kashmir recently, and therefore probably will be able to get avail of the Udaan program that Mr. Chinoy talks about. Basically, we work with a large number of companies in Bombay because the funding comes from there. Most of the large corporations and banks work with us, and they work with us over an extended period of time. So we are happy that we have good partners and that we are able to provide service and able to help in skilling a small part of the 350 million people who constitute our target audience, which is between the ages of 16 to 25, extendable to 30. Now look at 350 million. This is the population dividend. These are the people who are ultimately not going to get an opportunity. And what is the alternative for them? The alternative is do casual labor. Casual labor lasts only for 5 to 7 years. Thereafter, they go to alcoholism, substance abuse, violence at home, the wife being the bread earner, and the cycle goes again. I mean, so this is the kind of work we are doing. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. I think I had 10 minutes. I think I have stuck to the 10 minutes. Thank you.